Hello, Twin Flames. It's Magical Monday. Thank you for being here, sending you so much love. And I want to say a big thank you to everyone for sending me donations and all the beautiful emails I've received lately talking about your unions and your connections and about coming back together. And that's really what's going on and where it's at. And I shared the weekly reading yesterday and it was so powerful. It was about this week bringing in preparation and about your divine masculine being made whole for you, so he can give to you everything that you give to him. And I've just done a reading for members that really clarifies and confirms that too, about how the masculine is making decisions and is changing their life and is transforming for you. And we're being reminded as a divine feminine that everything counts on this journey, and to have patience and faith, to trust the divine timing of it all, that it's all coming at the right time for you. So let's do a reading then. So because it's a brand new week, I'm going to bring in an angel message too. So I'm going to use the Divine Feminine and Divine Masculine Message Tarot to see what the energy is. And the Twin Flame Tarot Made Easy to check in on the connection. We're going to bring a message in from heaven with the Energy Oracle. And then I'm going to use the Divine Structure Deck to see what else we need to know. So thank you for being here. And if you are new to the channel, welcome, subscribe, join our family, because we're here for you every day. And it's really powerful because I've shared day 24 today of the Divine Feminine Power Message, the series we're doing, and Prepare for Union came out. Really beautiful. And I shared a short this morning from the Nightmare Before Christmas Tarot, and it showed, you know, this kind of baby energy. Let me see if I've still got this card here. Okay, the energy of the divine masculine. Because if you go to that short video, you're going to see what it is anyway. But there it is. It was this card, okay? And what I'm feeling with this is a reminder that this journey is real. But it has to happen in divine timing. Because this card reminds me of a changeling. And changelings are like fairy babies, okay? And sometimes you don't know what you're getting with a changeling. It may look like a baby, but, you know, and very cute and cuddly and everything you want, but, okay, it's got a dark side, or it needs to heal, or it needs to grow up first. And that's really what the energy is with the masculine. You know, you may think you want him right now, but he wants to be whole for you. He wants to be healed of the past for you. He wants to be able to give to you everything that you give to him, so he doesn't give you a nasty surprise along the way. And the masculines do, you know, kind of give us a nasty surprise sometimes. We don't expect to go into separation. We don't expect things to suddenly end, and it hurts. So the big message is trust that he's going to be given to you, or he's going to come back to you at the right moment for you, where he can actually be the person that you actually need him to be. So let's see what the energy is today then. So what's the energy, please, angels, around the connection? And I'm really excited as well because my new deck, the companion deck for these ones, is now available. And it should be getting here at the end of the month. So fingers crossed. So what do we need to know? Oh, and just so you know as well, I actually did a channel update yesterday about what's coming. And a couple of people emailing me saying, is that all that's going to be on the channel? No, that's extras. So obviously we're doing everything we do every day. And then we're going to be doing those things extra. Okay, which will be the Advent messages, you know, the Tarot series coming in the new year, and anything else they guide me to do. So what's the energy around the connection, please, angels? What's the energy around the twins? What do we need to know? Here we go, that's the card there. What's the energy today around the divine masculine? What does he want to say to you, divine feminine? What's the energy? And if you want to know more about the masculine today, then check out the members reading, because I've done like an in-depth Celtic cross spread about him, okay? What's the energy around the feminine today? What does the feminine want to say? Or what do you need to know, divine feminine? What's happening in your energy today? There we go. Couple of cards coming out. And with the energy oracle, what's the energy today, angels? What do we need to know from heaven? What's the message today from heaven, please, for everyone? What's the message from heaven today? What do we need to know? Okay. Every day I'm shuffling. You know, sometimes when it takes a bit longer, it's because the energy is being prepared here. So the energy is, look at this coming together, very beautiful. And the Four of Wands is a card about building something, foundation, support, stability. you know, magic coming in. It can mean reunion, it can mean, you know, commitment, but this is definitely about coming together. And it's really powerful because I watched Cherie's reading today over on Divine Visions. She's another powerful divine feminine, and she also got this card. So, you know, it's showing you that sometimes the masculines don't grasp it when it's there, but there's a reason. Okay, if they don't kind of take the opportunity when it's there, there's a reason, because they are still healing and growing. So right now, you're being prepared for the future, and you're being prepared for this coming together energy. And this is so beautiful because we're in November right now as I record this in real time, and November is the energy of karmic endings and change. And December is obviously that celebration energy of coming together. So this is showing us again as we move forward, especially when Sagittarius comes in, you know, when we're in the Sagittarius kind of birth time, that there's this big period of coming together. So the angels are creating the way. You know, there's movement happening right now to bring you together. That's why so many of you are receiving communication, or you may be feeling something's coming in the 5D. You know, you feel it in your solar plexus, you feel it in your tummy. And you may also be having sleepless nights at this time, weird dreams, because you're purging out fear or you're releasing things to bring you together. So a lot of healing happening in sleep state too. So if you've had crazy dreams, if you've been struggling to sleep, maybe it's because you've been connecting with your twin, that's why. So he's saying to you, these are the masculine messages, you are everything I could ever want. And that's why we're coming together. You know, he sees you as a queen. And the Queen of Wands is about passion, fire, desire, confidence, strength, integrity, creativity, going for what you want. And that's how he sees you. You know, he sees you as power. He sees you as passion. He sees you as fire. And he's saying to you, you are everything I could ever want. And that means, Divine Feminine, that nobody compares to you, that you are special and unique, and nothing and no one can take that power away. He's saying to you, look at this, you are my true love, the one I dream about. So there's definitely a coming together happening in dreams right now. Even if you're not remembering it or you're not aware of it, it's happening. The Two of Cups energy, the love that you were meant to be. You are my true love. So again, he's reminding you of that today, regardless of how things seem in the physical world or what he needs to release. He's saying to you, you are my true love. You're the one I dream about, you. Look at this, Page of Cups. I am preparing to reach out. So he's coming to you, okay, coming together, things changing, and he's preparing for you. And this really resonates with the weekly reading. So if you haven't already watched that, go and check that out. I am preparing to reach out to you and communicate to you just how much I care. Why? Because he's saying to you today, you are my true love. And we are coming together. And nothing can stop that. But I am dealing with my ego. So again, you know, he's showing you there is things he's dealing with too. And this is very realistic. You know, it's not like he's saying, oh, it's all wonderful and fabulous and hearts and roses. He's saying, no, I deal with fear too. I deal with my ego, my insecurity, my pain. And you are everything I want. And I'm afraid that I'm going to let you down, or I'm going to fail you, that I'm going to hurt you. And it causes tears. It causes pain. It causes chaos and upheaval within his mind. And sometimes that can hold him back until he's ready to give. Until he's ready to reach out and ready to show you love. He doesn't want to be between two worlds. He doesn't want to be back and forth. He doesn't want to be hurting you. He doesn't want to be driving himself crazy in his own mind. He wants to be free and able and capable to be with you. So he's saying, I am dealing with my ego and any conflict that may mean to be able to come to you. And feminines, for you, we've got, I am finding my place in the world. So in the times where you're not together, the times where you are being prepared to come together, you find your way in the world. You know, you realize why you've come and how far you've come. You start working on service and mission and purpose and realizing that you are a psychic being connected with source. I'm reflecting on and healing the past through meditation and self-care. What a beautiful message. So while the masculine is dealing with his ego, you know, while he's preparing to reach out to you and come to you, you're healing the self, working on you, which is the best thing to do. You know, whenever you guys comment and you say, I've had enough of this journey, I'm exhausted with these, I always say focus on you. And that's not, you know, a cop out. That's me saying, don't focus on him. Okay, let him deal with his ego. Let the universe take care of it. Let the angels sort him out or her out. And you focus on you. Self-care, meditation. And what is meditation? Calming the mind. Coming back into the now. You can do that through a guided meditation, through breath work and healing, or going for a walk, or going to your favourite place, or going for a drive, whatever calms your energy down and helps you to feel at peace. That's what meditation is. And self-care is giving back to you, realising that you are enough, that you are special, that nobody compares to you. And I hope you can tell me how you feel. So you're saying to your masculine, well, you're saying to me that you're going to reach out to me and tell me how much you care and that I'm your true love. I really do hope you can tell me how you feel. So it's like you're saying, well, you've told me all this before in the 5D. You know, I've heard it all before. When's it going to happen? So this is faith that he will be able to open up to you, Divine Feminine. And you're saying, I'm excited about our future. I'm excited about being with you. I'm excited about our union and the relationship that we will share when we come together. I'm excited. So feel it today. Feel it. Get excited about it because the best is yet to come. And that's really been shown to you by heaven, that celebrations are ahead and there's beauty coming into your life. So the angel message is broken heart. So I know it hurts. And the angels are really showing that to you there. They know it hurts. They've heard your pain. They've heard you asking for help. They've heard your prayers and they are answering them. And they are reminding you that in the separation, it's when the magic happens. It's where, you know, all the power takes place. You know, the wound, as Rumi said, is where the light goes in. When we get hurt, we heal. And it's a journey. You know, it's a journey to heal the broken heart. It's a journey sometimes of the broken hearted because, you know, when we're hurting and in pain, we heal. And, you know, it's so special. You know, like being with George is a blessing. And you and your twin flame are a blessing. And one day you'll look back at this today and you'll think, why was I wondering? Why was I doubting? Why was I ever in fear? Because that broken heart and everything I went through healed me. It grew me. It made me stronger. Without that, I wouldn't be on this journey now. So you've been reminded that it's a journey. It's not about the destination. It's about the journey. It's about finding your way. It's about the feelings and the ecstasy and the elevation of everything. The way you raise your vibration. It's how you get through those dark times and you find the light. It's how you persevere. It's how you carry on. And you're being directed right now because all paths lead home. And you're being reminded of that too. Okay, sometimes we take a direct kind of journey to union and sometimes we take a detour to it. But whatever path we take or don't take, all paths lead home. And we've got the world. You have the world in your hands. You are a leader. You are a creator. You are strong. You can have, be and do whatever you desire. There's no limits apart from the ones you create in your mind. So you're breaking through with those limits. And the world is about completion and change and movement and power. And it's reminding you you're moving towards a new beginning. You know, and I'm really seeing this as the world changing and evolving into the golden age. And it's really powerful because, you know, one of our soul brothers asked me yesterday about the golden age. And, you know, this is what I'm feeling here. 2029, on the verge of the golden age, you know, in 2030, what we're moving into. So you've been reminded about your world mission, the reason you've come, that you have a mission for the world to heal humanity and help to bring in peace. And the angel of love is all around you. The answer is love. Love is the answer to all of your questions. Love conquers fear. Love conquers all things. Love creates the way. Love is the reason you're here, to learn love, to feel love, to be love. And the angel of love, and I'm feeling this is Archangel Jophiel today, allowing you to see with the eyes of love, to see things from a higher perspective, like the giraffe, seeing it from a taller point of view. The angel's helping you to respond to your situation with love instead of reacting with fear. And we've got anxiety. So release any anxiety, especially about when they're going to contact you, if they're going to contact you. Let this reassure you today, because he's saying to you, I am. I am. And I am are powerful words of creation. I am preparing to reach out. And we've got this is a week of preparation. I am preparing to reach out and communicate to you just how much I care. And he wants to tell you that you are his true love. And you are the one that they are dreaming about right now. And this is what you've been showed in dreams. And you are everything I could ever want. These are things he's going to tell you when he communicates to you. You are the one, you are everything to me, the only one I want, but I am dealing with my ego. And ego edges the goodness out. So don't let anxiety take over. And this is really the message that came through for members today about being patient, trusting, having faith, because, you know, it's worth waiting for and it truly is. So trust in the love today. Keep the faith. You've got this and heaven has got you. The best is yet to come. Your union is blessed and protected and you are safe. Have a great day and I'll see you soon.